Control Basic is the programming language used in KMC Conquest controllers. With it, you can write programs that evaluate and modify objects on the controller and send communication messages across the network. We refer to point passing as reading or writing values between controllers or devices on the network. In this video, we're going to be looking at a few code examples on point passing. In our first example, we need to know the total load of cooling and heating from each downstream VAV controller that is connected to an air handler controller. The first line states that every time 10 seconds goes by, we will run the subroutine VAV load. This routine reads the points that we have specified, loop 1 and loop 2, on the VAVs located at address 33 and 34 in our system. These values are written to variables in our air handler controller, AV1 through AV4. When the controller gets to a line of code that references an off-panel point, a network message is generated. Here we should point out that there is a wait command between each device instance in the code. This forces the entire program to wait for the specified amount of time, in this case, 1 second. Using the wait command throttles the number of messages or requests that are put out on the network and allows us to keep our network moving quickly. We are also grouping requests to the same panel. The controller will use read property multiples for these requests rather than just read property messages. Again, limiting the number of messages pushed out to the network. Remember, when you use the wait command in a control basic program, the entire program will wait for that specified amount of time. This means that no other code in that program will be executed during that duration. For this reason, it is the best practice to put all the off-panel programming in dedicated programs in the controller. Other programs that control the sequence of the equipment would operate as expected as the point passing programs are waiting. An alternate syntax for creating these types of point passing requests is NetPoint. NetPoint creates a local cache for off-panel values that can then be referenced from other programs. This can help manage the timing of the off-panel requests as the controller will handle the wait and interval functions in the background. Let's look at a different way we can write similar code using the NetPoint command. At first glance, this code may seem more complex, but ultimately, it may help speed up your controller operation. This routine will grab the present value of each point we want to request, namely the loop values from VAVs 33 and 34, every 10 seconds. Every 10 seconds, the cache in the controller will update automatically, reducing the time needed to execute the control basic program. The power loss statement ensures NetPoints are only set up once following a power loss or restart. NetPoint Cache 1 will turn on caching in your controller. This command must be done prior to any code using that data. The NetPoint cache must be enabled in each program using the NetPoint cache. In our case, before the last two lines of our code example. As you get started with point passing and more advanced control basic programming, start small, be consistent, and test your code often. For more information on control basic and point passing, check out the other videos in this series. Or to learn more about any of the solutions from the building geniuses at KMC, visit us on the web at kmccontrols.com.